Hello, and welcome back to my Oreimo read-through. In the previous episode, Saori arranged for us a small meeting with Kuroneko, which didn't go as well as our protagonist wanted it. Let's continue with the story. That Kuroneko, why did she get angry all of a sudden? Was it something I did? But we had a good mood going on just earlier. I just don't get it. However, we tried talking to each other for a while today, and from that I understood that Kuroneko is definitely hiding something. Something that's causing her to worry. Both Kino and Saori said that they didn't know anything either. Kuroneko, why doesn't she try to find someone to discuss it with? Doesn't she have Kirino, Saori, and all those friends from school? Lots of people that she can ask for support. Despite that, she stays silent and tries to keep important decisions to herself. Is she going somewhere else without telling us or something? Disappearing without any explanation, it certainly seems like something she would do. Well, if she thought it over and arrived at that conclusion, then that's fine, but I just hope that she's not going to rush a decision without consulting anyone and then come for help when the deed is done. Okay, I've had enough of stuff like this. If you're worried about something, you should at least talk to someone about it. It would, if anything, at least make you feel better. Right? We are friends after all. Well then, it's about time to give Kuroneko a call. I'm currently unable to answer your call. So she's not answering after all. What should I do? I thought I'd talk to her, but I got the answering machine instead. And since I'm being that serious about it, it'd be better to talk to her directly. Still, maybe I should just let her know that I'm prepared for anything. I'll stop for now and contact her directly tomorrow. Huh? I can't believe this. Huh? Kirino is on her phone? You delusional cult lover. I won't ever hear you out on anymore. Is she talking with Kirino right now? So, to put it simply, Kuroneko was talking with Kirino, therefore she can answer my call. After that, I got up and tried to ask Kirino about Kuroneko, but I can't get anything at all from my little sister, who was still angry. Kyo-chan. Did you spend your holidays? It seems like that you were exhausted this morning. Also, you seem to be scolding. I'm doing no such thing. So, I'm right. Can it be because of Kuroneko-san? Your intuition is spot on. You didn't contact Kuroneko-san during the holidays. Well, yeah, that girl, even though I tried very hard to contact her. I see. Times like this, it's really great to be in the same school as her and having a chance to meet her as long as we're in school. Kyo-chan is a really capable senpai. I wouldn't be this charred if I was capable.
I will support both Kyo-chan and Kuroneko-san. Really now. Thank you.
Well then, I'm off.
Yeah, good luck.
And so I went to Kuroneko's classroom.
Looks like she isn't around. Where did she go?
Perhaps I should ask around.
Hey, you over there.
Yes.
Do you know where Kuroneko went? I can't possibly call her Kuroneko in front of her classmates.
Koko-san. She disappeared as soon as the chime rang.
Oh, so you don't have any idea where she went?
Yeah, sorry.
I see. Thank you.
However,
Ellie?
I was told that a third-year senpai were to come. Tell him to never come look at me in this classroom again.
Oh, alright. That girl, she sure has a way to make a fool out of someone. Classroom. Kuroneko's classroom. Akagi's sister is also in the same class as Kuroneko. It was said that because of her eccentric speech, she was a loner at first. However, looked like she's able to find friends of similar interests and blend into the class bit by bit. Okay. Why did you tell a fellow classmate that? Won't this cause a misunderstanding? Good grief, that girl absolutely have to get hold of her now. This time, I must. I was given a hard time during the lunch break, but this, I'll definitely settle it this time, Kuroneko. It's useless going to her classroom at all. In that case, the club room. Yeah. So she didn't come, Kuroneko. Damn it. If it comes to this... excuse me, did Goku come for club activities recently? Nope. She has been appearing in the club room lately. I see. Okay, let's check that out. The club Kuroneko joined. Akagi's sister, like Kuroneko, also joined the same club. Because of certain things that happened in this club, I happen to be a member also. However, I used examinations as a reason to not take part in the activities. Okay. She always goes home immediately after school, so she should probably be at the shoe rack by now. Thank you. Okay, let's check this out as well. Shoe rack, the school's shoe rack. It will be crowded during the store at the end of the school day. During Valentine's Day, when students open their compartments, their hearts will beat furiously, but I haven't received any presents or love letters since birth, nor have I seen anyone receive them before. I've been thinking that this is all but an urban legend. Kuroneko's shoes are still around. Victory! This way, she'll definitely come here. All I have to do is wait here. And don't look creepy at all. Yay. Yo, I've been stalking for you. I mean, waiting for you. Goodbye. Hey, hold it there. Well, then,
Okay. What is it? I have something to talk. Oh wait, shit. I have something to talk to you about. It seems that you have mustered up some enthusiasm, but it's still useless, no matter how many times you say it. I don't know if it will be useless or not. Come on, accompany me for a bit. Unfortunately, I don't have the time to talk to you. You might not have stuff to talk about, but I have. Oh, come on, me. You might not have stuff to talk about, but I have things I need to say to you. You're sure being forceful. It isn't useless if I don't do that to the current you. So, you're trying to twist my will with force? Nothing of that sort. Just won't listen if I don't speak more forcefully. After all, I have had some experience before. I see. However, in any case, I don't interfere. I'm going to talk to you on the way home. It's certainly a waste of time being forced to stay here. Fine, I'll go to the club room instead. Aren't you planning on going home? I just remembered I had something to do. So you just don't want to be with me? It seems that you perceive that quite well. That's exactly what I feel. Am I really such a hindrance to you? Absolutely. What do you want me to say this time to reject you? Anything will do. Just say it. Alright. Then I will. You're a hindrance. I'll say it as many times as necessary. To be entirely honest, you're being a pain. Reflect on how your own action can cause troubles for others. How many rejections will it take for that low IQ brain of yours to understand? What? You're being quite harsh. That's because you've already done this. I don't get it. I'm just worried about you. Why are you rejecting me? Me! Not just me, Kirino too, everyone too. You won't understand, even if I were to say it. You wouldn't know that. Oh, you wouldn't know that. Quiet. Drive these words into your skull. Stop following me around. I'm getting more worried the more you put it this way. It's useless to worry. Just accept it. If the person in question says so. That's why I said I'm getting more worried when you're acting like this. Do you know what none of your business is? Is that how it is right now? Yes, exactly. Do you really get it? Nope, I don't get it at all. Oh really? Then I'll put it across clearer. Since tedious. So it's better if you stop it. That's what I'll do if I think it's required. But from what it seems, there's no choice but to pester you endlessly. What? That's why I won't let you escape anymore. What? What's going on? Go this instant, otherwise I'll scream. What am I, a pervert? It looks like. Isn't that the case? It's because you're trying to drag me away against my will. That's because you're not being honest. That's a horrible argument. How many times must I say for you to understand that I don't have the leisure to speak to you with you? Anyway, just follow me. Well, okay. Seems that there isn't anyone else in the club room. There won't be anyone interfering if we were to talk inside. Good grief. What are you planning doing by bringing me here? I'm not planning to do anything. I just have something to ask you, Koroneko. Okay. What on earth did you want to ask me? I'm sure you would know since you took the time to listen to me after all. Isn't that a given? You sure are direct, aren't you? Since I am accompanying you on such a senseless errand, just spare me the sarcasm. Jeez, whatever. I'll get straight to the point. I'll ask you once more. Tell me the problems you're having. It's not like I need to tell you anything. Why are you still saying that? I'm worried about you. What a troublesome person. I'll certainly be regrettable if I were to tell you. What is it regrettable? Who will regret it? It will be me. I'm regretting that I mentioned this in the first place. I get your enthusiasm already. So, you finally understand. Yes, it is simply reckless passion. I'm totally being serious. I'm not being reckless. If you don't retain your composure, it's the same. I said that I understood your enthusiasm, did I not? However, this has nothing to do with you. How does this have nothing to do with me? If it's happening around me, a fine argument, but if you end up getting involved in everything, won't you be up your neck in work? Oh, of course, there are priorities I need to handle, which is why I'm dealing with you first. It can have nothing to do with me, it concerns you. Is it because of your kindness? What did you say? I couldn't quite hear it. Make matters note. Anyway, I ought to thank you since you are doing this for my sake. I see, then. Tell me. But I didn't want to. Why is that? It will certainly cause trouble for you if you were to tell. If I were to tell you. Why would it cause trouble for me? Because it'll hurt you too. If that's the case, wouldn't not telling me anything cause me pain as well? Aren't you just mindlessly getting yourself into trouble? And it's not like that, but it's really troubling. Whether it's troubling or not, it isn't up to you to decide, it's for me to decide. True. What you have said is correct, but since you already know about it, then why can't you understand that I don't wish to cause harm to you as well? That's... You've raised a bunch of one-sided theories, but those are all more like irrational thoughts than theories. But isn't what's really important how one thinks and not how one expresses himself? Needless protesting, that's what best describes you. Good grief, you just don't give up, do you? However, that's exactly the reason why I'm not telling you. That's right, Senpai is a good person, so if I speak up, you'll surely... No, I can't even say definitely, you'll definitely get involved. Are you saying that I shouldn't? Yes, if you don't understand the need to be reserved, then you're truly a selfish man. Yeah, that's because I'm stubbornly nice. Called nice because I preserve my actions. That's why your convenience is irrelevant. Well, I don't know what trouble you have exactly, but I can roughly feel how much you don't want to tell me about it. But I'm not that easily convinced. It seems no matter how you hold me down. This is not about others, but you. How can I treat like it's some stranger? see.
Oh yeah, that's right.
So, am I considered one of your important friends?
Gah. So embarrassing to hear to repeat it like that.
Well, now that I came so far, it'd be wrong to try to dodge the subject.
Yeah, you might say that.
Heh, is that so? That's fine then. I'll give you a reward, since you answered so honestly.
Why are you looking down at me?
Wait, a reward? Yes. I shall answer you.
Really? Okay, let's check this out. Important friend. Important friend. Although it's embarrassing to be called that, it's a sentence that doesn't make one unhappy. In other words, close friends. However, if an old friend that hasn't been seen for a long time were to say, I'm one of your important friends, right? Take it as helping me, can you please buy this lucky pot? Then this friendship is practically finished.
Okay. Really? Thank you. I guess you have heard from Sari about my circle taking part in the upcoming summer at Comic Kid.
Yeah, I've heard about it.
That piece of manuscript hasn't been proceeding as smoothly as planned. So now I'm falling behind and trying to turn it around, that's all.
That's all? Okay.
Yes, that's all.
Really?
You sure are persistent.
Huh. Then leave this to me, I will...
I don't need it.
I haven't even said anything yet.
You would say, allow me to help out, anyway, right?
Can you read my mind? No, you're just a transparent person, Kyosuke.
Do you know what an unwelcome favor means? That's what you are right now. Can you please not misunderstand? I'm only telling you this because you're being persistent, and I don't have the slightest intention of letting you take part. So please, don't do any more unnecessary things.
Unnecessary things? I just wanted to help you.
Haven't I said it before? It's better to keep away from hindrances. These are all obstacles when it comes to production of works.
Am I really being a hindrance?
That's right. It's troublesome if I were to allow an amateur to take part. Do you understand now? Can you even draw manga?
It's true that I can, but I also know this... An assistant is required when it comes to manga, right? Furthermore, there are many other things to do that even an amateur could help out with.
Oh, this is a surprise. Senpai actually knows about these things.
That's because I have known you long enough. That's why I know just this much.
Hmm. Alright. This is all just a facade anyway.
A facade?
I shall inform you of the truth. It will surely hurt you, but you'd still want to hear it anyway, right? Therefore, are you prepared?
Yeah, it may be anything. You have some nerve. Well then, allow me to tell you. To me, creating is the act of taking a fragment of my mind and recreate it, sublime it. It is no exaggeration when I say that I created something new. Which is why I shall not allow anyone to trespass on this domain. Especially someone like you who doesn't even know where he stands. Never. Although the method of putting this across is unique, in short, isn't it still about that? Don't come close to me. Isn't that what you're trying to say, Kroneko? I should have said it before. If one were to step into the domain, punishment will be met. Your punishment is my rejection. Are you able to withstand this punishment? Ah, I can't stand it. I can't bear it at all. No! I'm sorry. I'm glad that you understand. Damn it, I sure am useless. I didn't expect to be rejected so straightforwardly. Just when I thought Kroneko would listen to me if I pushed him strongly. Oh, and I thought our relationship would be fixed. And this is the first time I have felt like this. It's really unbearable to be completely ignored by someone. Completely ignored, huh? Good grief. It's kind of depressing when I consider the possibility that this could last forever. I know, I'm letting down Sawori who's counting on me, but after she said that to me, what am I supposed to do? One of me overestimated me too. That's the wishes of the person concerned. There is nothing I can do. I have also let Kena down, but I'm sure you'll be fine. You and Kroneko's friendship won't be broken by something like that. But as for me... A phone call.
Say, I've heard this from my sister today.
Yeah?
That girl looks like she's in terrible shape.
Terrible?
Seems like she's constantly pushing her limits. And she continues to drive herself reaching her limits. That's a vicious cycle.
Sounds like the worst pattern.
Yeah, a splendid route to self-destruction. The senpai at the club wanted to stop her, but it seems that she doesn't listen to him at all, right?
Oh, I would have stopped her earlier if it were so simple.
No, that's true. They intend to ban her from entering the club room, though I doubt her having her overexert herself somewhere people can monitor as any. Better.
Oh, really?
If Kornaka's pressured, I'd like to support her. You know that the feeling hasn't changed, but if the person in question doesn't desire help, what would happen if I were to help her?
I'm still unable to find an answer for that, but...
That's right. If I were to ask Kagi, who's not really related to Kroneko, would that be good?
No. I should stop. It's not like I have something to literally talk about. And also, this is something I must get the answer to by myself. That's why. I'm hanging up.
Okay, I don't really get it, but good luck anyway.
But what are you planning to do?
Who knows?
I guess I'll try thinking about it some more. See ya.
What's up? Something wrong?
Oh, wait a second. What's up? Something wrong?
It's nothing. Nothing at all.
But you were just staring over here just now.
Ah, no. You're just looking over here because I was talking about Kuroneko.
That's natural.
Oh, you must be worried about her as well.
I would be worried about her.
I want to feel bored even if she isn't around.
In other words, she means I can't help but get worried about her.
Poor Kena.
She looks like she can't bear it anymore, but even if she won't say it. A close friend not being here all of a sudden.
Well, it's not like she can say anything about other people.
That's exactly why she didn't make a big fuss about it, but staying quiet about it is alright.
The pain of having normal daily life destroyed.
I know that feeling very well. It's not just Kino, even though I find it quite painful being unable to see Kuroneko like usual.
As for what Kuroneko said, our world is about to crumble.
But if I want not to step into Kuroneko's world, then it will also destroy our daily lives. Our world.
Stepping into Kuroneko's world, I guess it means trying my best to turn things back to what it was.
I'm sure that's it.
Well, I don't know if it's possible to turn back to before even if I do step in.
Do you have that kind of right?
She's kind of reluctant, so can I even set foot into her issues?
You are an idiot.
Huh?
It's nothing. But besides that, go and do something already.
I know that.
Do you understand? Then get moving as always.
What's with Kurino?
Oh, our dad.
Kyosuke.
Huh?
Have you gotten yourself a girlfriend?
Huh?
What if he think of he's asking?
I've heard from your mother. You've been bringing your girlfriend home recently.
Is he talking about Kuroneko?
No. That's I'm just helping her. I was making a game.
My mom's so loose-lipped, and moreover, a misunderstanding led to her telling Dad.
I've also heard she hasn't been here lately. Have you two quarreled?
You could say that. Although this misunderstanding isn't really great, but it doesn't seem bad discussing with his dad.
I don't have the slightest idea what she's thinking, so I'm in a bit of a pinch.
I see. You are like me, socially awkward.
Seems like it.
To cross paths with one another is something that can happen to anyone. Also, this will easily become the cause for clashes and quarrels.
Although I haven't seen you and Mom quarrel before.
Well, that's just because we don't let you see it. I'm like what you said, even now. There are times when I don't understand what your mother is going on about. Not knowing what the other has, what the other is angry about, not knowing what the other is unhappy about, not knowing what the other is thinking about. The more you're concerned about the other party, all the more easily for your actions and words to hurt them.
In situations like that, what should I do?
It's hard to say. There isn't a standard answer for that. All you can do is to think about it seriously and take the action you think that is the best. Kyosuke, don't think about being successful. It's impossible for us.
Impossible?
Yes. However, even if you have your own way of doing things, so allow me to take a look at it sometime.
I don't want to have this situation twice.
Even the useless can do something if they put effort in it.
Oh wow, he just called them useless.
I get it, I'll give it a try, Dad. I see. If you two were to reconcile, introduce her to us. I'm looking forward to it.
Like I said, that's just a misunderstanding.
I strengthened my resolve to... I strengthened my resolve to face Kronek once more. Because I received encouragement from many, many people. I don't know why, but it just switched to auto mode for some reason. I'll work hard in my own way, even if I'm rejected by her again. What's going on? Okay. Just let me check. Oh shit. I work hard in my own way, even if I'm rejected by her again. I've made such a resolve to myself. Yo! It looks like I haven't made much progress.
What do you want? You should have a lot of free time if you can come to the freshman's classroom during summer.
It's not because I have spare time. I'm here because I have something to do.
Is it something that specifically requires you to be here?
It does.
You're unexpectedly stubborn today. Stubborn? What are you talking about?
I'm sure you know about it. If you're being so reckless, I'm sure you're about to reach your limit.
Hey, not at all. I'm really doing what is necessary to accomplish what I want.
How stubborn.
Hey, this is something that anyone would be able to do if they wanted to. Doing your best to reach your goal. How is that wrong?
People don't just work themselves to exhaustion.
Look at you, you're visibly swaying. It's useless, no matter what you say, I have no intention of listening to you.
So, anything I say is useless?
Yes, that's right, so leave me be. Please, don't stop me anymore, it's just a little more so.
Do you understand that everything will be over until you collapse at the moment just for a little more?
Of course. However, this time, it's just my ability is still not sufficient enough. It's a pity to be unable to finish something. I have some regret, but it's mighty too hard to walk this path of sacrifice.
What kind of desire is that?
As expected. It looks like your opinion differ. Isn't it about time you let me go? This amount of time is very important to me right now.
But you haven't listened to anything I've said.
It's pointless, no matter what you say. Don't you understand? Both of us have no intention of giving way.
Of course, I'm here just to stop you.
Really? However, I won't give in, no matter what you say. So please,
Stop wasting my time. The time I allocated for you is hereby over. Oh, what's the meaning of that?
It means exactly what I just said. At the very least, we should meet and see you after the manuscript is done.
You'll only cause me trouble when you look for me.
Do you mean you won't even come to school?
Yes. Work can be done at home.
Are you needed to go that far to avoid me? And I can't even care about you, is that what you're saying?
It's as you have said, having that intention is enough. So please, don't interfere unnecessarily. This is only one thing I want you to do right now.
And that would be?
You ignoring me and get lost.
That again.
How about it? If you're really worried about me, can you do me this small favor?
What do you mean by ignoring you?
It's simple. Don't talk to me even if meet. It'd be like we don't know each other. Treating me as a complete stranger would do.
Is that your true wish?
Yes, that's right.
You are totally okay with that?
Obviously, I myself am wishing for it.
Oh, damn it. Is there no way I can stop you?
Obviously, I would not be stopped by you. Well, that's that. That is why I shall now bid farewell to you.
Damn. Isn't there anything I can say? To see her walk off unable to do anything? It's so frustrating. Could I just stand here gritting my teeth? Hey, Koroneko? Koroneko? Damn it! To the infirmary! Oh wow, she just collapsed. Although, I can only perform a simple medical examination here. This is just a simple case of overwork and lack of sleep. Whew. Well, that's good to hear. Well then, I will be leaving for a while. Let me know when she comes around, alright? And that's what the doctor said, Koroneko. It looks like Koroneko isn't going to be waking up anytime soon. Oh, wake up soon. I have to scold you no matter what. Besides, this is the first time I'm so close to Koroneko's face. Oh no. We haven't been this close because of the distance between us. Her cheeks are a little red, but it seems that she has calmed down. That's really great. She's been sulking a lot of recently. It'll be great if her mood gets better when she wakes up. Koroneko, are you awake?
This place is...
That's an infirmary, don't you remember? You collapsed all of a sudden.
I do remember, quite clearly.
Oh jeez, but since you're unexpectedly full of vigor, I'm quite relieved.
Besides, just the lack of sleep and all work, isn't it? You don't have to be so worried.
Even if it's nothing big, if you collapse, it would be all for nothing.
All
right. Initially, I thought that I would be able to continue like this. I'm really worthless. Good grief. I can handle you. You won't listen to me when I say it again, right? Of course. I'm not obliged to listen to you. Yeah. Well, I'll just say it again just for the sake of it. In short, stop overworking yourself. I can always come out and to stop you. As for what happened this time, I feel it's you who got me angry for no reason in the first place. Yes, it's my bad. Just take it as my fault then. But you know, you should take extra care since you already collapsed once. It would be troublesome if you aren't lucky. It's okay to make me worried. After all, it's me who was concerned for you on my own accord. However, if you're causing the others to worry, you should stop. It's better to avoid making everyone sad. That's right. Something I don't wish to see either. Yeah, that's so. It makes me happy that you're willing to listen, finally. Well then, I'll go get the doctor here. Hold it. What is it? Okay. I have a question for you. What is it? Why? Why are you so concerned about me? Why? Why do you ask? Isn't it just someone else's problem to you after all? Of course, I would be concerned. How many times have I said that? I'm worried about you. That's just you being nosy. Since it's being nosy to you, I'm really worried about you. So worried that I don't even know what to say. My, this isn't really an answer, isn't it? Although, can it be counted as an answer? It can be said that it's very much your way of doing things. I'll just say something honest. You have my heartfelt thanks for being worried about me. I see, but I don't understand your feelings. My feelings? Yes, what are you really thinking about when you're trying to stop me? And that's what the origin of that thought. What do you gain from stopping me? It's fine. Even if you don't get it, I didn't think that you would understand it. I see. Not troubling people. That's a good thing. However, don't push yourself. That I refuse. Why? It's because I'm a creator. Huh, what does that mean? You can't create an excellent product if you don't experience the hardship of a creator. I'm not a genius, so I'm destined to walk on this thorny path. I don't know what you're talking about. How did even we get into this topic? Creations are often accompanied by huge hardships. It's just like walking in the dark. There is no such thing as the definite answer. Although, some paths are indeed better than others, always close by us. And to continuously look for those is our purpose as creators. Even so, surely you don't want to push yourself too much. No, that is necessary. You won't understand since you're not a creator. I can't say anything if you put it that way. You weren't so exhausted when you were working on that game previous time. The present and the past, they're completely different. I'll definitely create a good piece of work when I've experienced such hardships.
That is what I firmly believe in.
Isn't that the wrong assumption? Just because you're going through tough times, you're using that reason to comfort yourself.
Who knows? However, it's true that many creators had walked the same path. And so I will walk upon this path too.
But what's with that? Creation of World Tower? Is there only suffering in creating?
No, I don't feel the pain. There are many types of joy I'm experiencing too, which is why I'm able to endure this situation.
Endure? Are you training to be a monk?
I guess. This might even come close to it. It's just suffering for different objectives. They devote themselves to the gods, and I devote myself to my masterpieces. That's the only difference. This is my own decision. It's something that I've decided to finish, with my spirit, belief, and pride on the line. So, please, speak no further.
But you know, isn't it slightly different since people are worried about you?
Imagine collapsing and getting sent to the hospital. Kirin or Saori and the members of the club would be worried sick about you.
If you aren't careful, the club activities could be very well suspended because of that too.
And? As I told you before, I'm not obliged to listen to your words.
Oh, you're like a little sister to me.
Isn't it natural for me, a brother, to take care of you? I see.
That's about it. Well, that's all I want to say.
I'll be leaving then.
It's fine the way it is now. Our worries won't be wasted as long as I'm able to help her. Just a little. If she's going to be reckless again, I'll stop her before she collapses.
Huh? Hold on.
What is it? Huh? What's wrong?
The oracle just now.
Hey, what's wrong with your Kronika? What oracle are you talking about?
I'd like to have a life cancelling session.
Okay. It's a vicious circle. Everyone is doing this nowadays. Huh. Yep.
Stop laughing. I'm being serious.
I'm being serious here as well. Life cancelling, you say? Oh well, I never expected that from you.
I've heard a long time from her. She said, with a sense of pride too. I'm sure you will listen to what I had to say, if I were to put it this way, will you not? So, could you listen to my troubles?
Of course, bring it on. And with that, Koroneko's life counseling session started. I didn't really think the situation would develop this way.
I've been drawing the event manuscript all by myself. I just want to confirm how far I could go by my own right now. But it seems I can't finish by the deadline if this goes on. That's why. Could you help me out?
Oh, this is my first time seeing such an honest and docile Kroneko. I mean,
isn't it the same as the suggestion I gave before? Right. Just for now, I'll admit it. I was being stubborn before. Is it alright about this, and will you accept it?
Of course I will. Since you've put it that way, I'll help you no matter what.
I see. Then, starting from tomorrow, I'll be counting on you.
Yep. Yeah, please do.
Good grief. We've made a very big detour, however this detour seems to have some merit.
Alright, I think that's a good point to finish this episode. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.